We have a special guest on the hotline, Judi.
Yes, we do.
You may have read about Weedman this morning. It seems like his appeals were denied, and they discounted the 67 days part of the time he spent in jail as an appeal.
This is a shame.
It's a shame. So let's get it right from the horse's mouth. Ed Forchion, NJ Weedman, is on the line. Ed, I read some of the comments after the article, too, and people just think it's a travesty of justice that you're still there. But do you have anything new to report to us?
There's been a lot of things going on, to be honest with you. Just now, when you said that, that was the first time I heard it. Yesterday, I was told that the judges were writing the order, but I didn't get to talk to anybody until just now. You just gave me breaking news.
But Ed, you called yesterday to say you wanted to talk. What were you going to say?
Well, I was going to tell you that there's going to be an order, and I really thought I would know this morning, and I didn't. No one ever faxed it to me, nothing. You just told me.
Are you kidding me?
Well, no, the story that we have as of 7:04 last night, and this is from NJ.com, a state appeals court Wednesday upheld several recent decisions by the judge presiding over the witness tampering case of Ed Weedman, Forchion.
Wow.
Since Forchion has been detained in jail in the case, three pretrial motions have been filed, and each took some time to decide. The judge, Anthony Massey, in Mercer County, found those days were excluded from the 180 days the state has to either try, release, or move to detain a defendant once they have been indicted as part of the new bail reform laws. So what does this mean, Ed, that
It means that when the judge, you know, I did my 180 days, they still didn't put me on trial. The judge added 67 days, you know, they call it excludable time because, you know, my ex-lawyer filed the motion to remove himself, the public defender filed the motion.
But they still held you. So they were excluding those 67 days because you were appealing it. That is such nonsense.
How are they even allowed to do this?
I don't know how any of this is allowed.
Chris Christie and Senator Sweeney bamboozled the people to vote on it. That's really what happened. And the ACLU supports it. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, if they're allowed to do it, what is the judge's motivation behind it?
Well, I don't want to tee the judge off by, you know, bad-mouthing him right now.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
You know, but so I'm not going to go there. But I will tell you that, okay, I've been saying from day one, bring it on. Bring me to trial. But the prosecutor has decided to do this stall and delay tactic to drag me out, get as much punishment as possible out of me, before ultimately a jury's going to exonerate me. No jury in America would convict me of witness tampering because I outed a witness on my Facebook page. I didn't threaten them. I didn't do anything. And it's all true.
It's all public knowledge.
So they know that, and that's why they're
churning this case to punish him, even though they know, because they know they won't get a just punishment out of a jury in a trial. Ed, it says here that the clock would have expired September 1st, but now because they're throwing this bogus 67 days in, it won't expire till November 6th, according to the decision.
Yeah, and like I said, all right, so they got to put me on trial now within the next 5 weeks. Five weeks, okay. I keep saying bring it on. You know, when I first got arrested, I said, you know, Mr. Onfrey should try this case himself. He should get this legal butt whipping from me himself. His assistants are doing the case, but I keep saying I am not convictable of this crime. Bring it on. And the prosecution keeps asking for extra time, delaying. They're just getting blood out of me that no will spit.
The prosecutor's office.
But yes. Why?
Because he embarrassed the cop in public, and he
you got your little punishment in.
We're watching this miscarriage of justice in slow motion before our eyes, and no one can do anything about it. And I know Christie stepped in for some gun things because it was a miscarriage of justice. As much as he may dislike Ed, he should step in here and say, "All right, guys,
please,
this is ridiculous."
Yeah. The funny thing is, though, I now have a dream team of lawyers. I have four lawyers now helping me in one way or the other. And like I said, I believe that no jury will find me guilty anyway. You know, I've been a proponent of jury nullification for the last 20 years.